With the release of MasterCam 2022, MasterCam now supports the use of steady rests in mill-turn machines. These steady rests can either be turret-mounted or standalone machine-integrated units. MasterCam mill-turn users will also notice that the MasterCam 2022 installation includes a list of pre-configured generic mill-turn machines. Let's use a turret-mounted steady rest from a generic mill-turn machine inside a pickoff operation. With the part file open, select the generic mill-turn TT machine file. This generic machine comes preloaded with a steady rest and the applicable pre-configured part handling operations. When the job setup menu appears, we now see the Work Support tab. In the lower turret field, right-click the steady rest entry. Here, we can either select a steady rest that lives inside this machine's component library, or we can navigate externally to select one. Let's select the incorporated steady rest and click OK. Change the setup type to single piece of stock, pickoff. The included generic machines do not support steady rests with a cutoff operation, but this workflow can be enabled in any applicable machine by a qualified machine developer. Select the solid body as part geometry. Pick a point on this face as the part stickout origin. And a point on this face for the pickoff origin. Click OK. In the part handling gallery, select pickoff. Here we can select a strategy that matches our machine configuration. Let's choose upper stream with lower steady rest. We can toggle through the list of operations contained inside this pickoff strategy until we land on position steady rest. The only user input required in this process is to select the point at which the steady rest should support the part during the pickoff. If a point is selected somewhere away from X0, an operation will automatically be added to shift the steady rest to the part center before clamping. Click OK to create the operations in the Operation Manager. In the automatically created second toolpath group, let's make a quick facing toolpath on the right spindle using the upper turret. Select all operations and send them to the Sync Manager. Here we see all the steady rest operations in the lower stream and all other operations in the upper stream. Right-click in the white space and select Expand All Operations. In the operation comments, we can see that operation number 4 is where the steady rest clamps onto the part. Once the steady rest is clamped, we can let the part handling operations begin. Let's sync the end of operation 4 to the unclamp line of operation 5. Operation 12 is where the steady rest follows the part during the subspindle's move to home position, so that too must be carefully synced. Sync the home line of operation 11 to the motion line of operation 12. Add a sync point after the motion as well to ensure that these two moves are completely synchronized. Save these changes back to the MasterCam file and launch simulation. When we click play, we see the upper turret move to its park location. The steady rest grips the part. The subspindle moves over and clamps onto the part. Everything moves to the right side of the machine as a single unit. And finally, we have our subspindle facing operation. With so many moving parts, it's extremely important to be able to simulate a process like this. MasterCam 2022 now gives users the ability to safely and confidently handle parts with a turret-mounted steady rest.